So let's step a step back and look at what we've achieved. We knew there was a measurement update, an emotion update, which is also called prediction. And we know that the measurement update is implemented by multiplication, which is the same as Bayes' rule. And the emotion update is done by total probability, or an addition. So we tackled the more complicated case. This is actually the hard one mathematically. And we solved it. We gave an exact expression. We even derived it mathematically. And you were able to write a computer program that implements this step of the Kármán filter. I don't want to go into too much depth here. This is a really, really easy step. Let me write it down for you. Suppose you live in a world like this. This is your current best estimate where you are. And this is your uncertainty. And now say you move to the right side a certain distance. And that motion itself has its own set of uncertainty. Then you arrive at a prediction that adds the motion command to the mean, and it has an increased uncertainty over the initial uncertainty. And intuitively, this makes sense. If you move to the right by this distance, in expectation, you are exactly where you wish to be, but you've lost information because your motion tends to lose information as manifest by this uncertainty over here. Now, the math for this is really, really easy. Your new mean is your old mean plus the motion, often called u. So if you move over 10 meters, this would be 10 meters. And your new sigma square is your old sigma square plus variance of the motion Gaussian. This is all you need to know. It's just an addition. And I won't prove it to you because it's really trivial. But in summary, we have a Gaussian over here. We have a Gaussian for the motion with u as the mean and r square as its own motion uncertainty. And the resulting Gaussian in the prediction step just adds these two things up, mu plus u and sigma square plus r square. Since it was so simple, let me quiz you. We have a Gaussian before the prediction step, for which mu equals 8 and sigma square equals 4. We then move to the right, a total of 10, with a motion uncertainty of 6. Now describe to me the predicted Gaussian and give me the new mu and the new sigma square.